For this assignment, we'll be using the empty scene in the robot lab. Open the empty scene, and then, to make sure that we maintain our empty scene, go to File, Save Scene As. Save it into the Scenes folder, and we'll call this Bouncing Ball. As usual, Unity takes you straight into the scene that you've just saved, so we're now working in the Bouncing Ball scene. A good first thing to do in Unity is make the classic Bouncing Ball that you may have done in other pieces of software. In the Models folder, we have some primitive shapes, such as the spherical semiflange and the cubic power cube, as well as a number of other different assets. From the Models folder, drag and drop the prop semiflange object into the scene. Remember that you can use the Translate tool to select and move it around. This can be done by dragging the handles or by dragging the planes on the object. You should notice that I'm using the F key to focus on that object and move the scene view in to focus on it too. To make sure that our object is lit by our dynamic lights, make sure that the layer of the semiflange is set to dynamic objects. Now you should see that our object is nicely lit, and in the mesh renderer, we can also check use light probes. Now our object will be properly lit within the scene. Next, we'll add a rigid body component. So click the Add Component button on the inspector and go to Physics, Rigid Body. However, we can't use a rigid body without a collider. So let's go to Add Component, Physics, Sphere Collider. This gives our spherical object a bounding area. And if we zoom in, you should see that there's a green outline going around it. Looking at the rigid body, you can see that we have properties for mass, drag, etc., and also a checkbox for use gravity. By default, this is checked, and that's exactly what we want to do here as well. And what we'll also do is affect the kind of friction that we want this object to have. By default, if I press play now, the object will fall to the floor. But what we want to do is add in a friction response too. This is handled by the material on the collider. So we're going to make a new physics material. So I'm going to select the assets folder, and then we'll make a folder for this. So click the create button and choose folder, and make a new folder in which to store your physics materials. Then, because we want to create this physics material inside that folder, select the folder, then go back to create and choose physics material. This creates it inside the folder. And as soon as you create it, you can then name it. And you should name it Bouncy, because that's what we're going to create. Before setting up this asset, I'm going to apply it to the object so that we don't forget later. So reselect the prop semiflange, and then drag Bouncy from the project panel and drop it onto the physic material setting in the component in the inspector. Now reselect the asset in the project panel, and we'll take a look at its settings. You can see here that a key one that we want to play with is bounciness. And I'm going to set this to 0.8. Now if I press play, what you'll see is that it bounces to a halt. The reason for this is bounce combine, because what this does is average the friction on the object and the object that it's colliding with, i.e. the floor. So whilst I've set this to 0.8, because it's averaging the two, what we're actually getting is 0.4. So what we'll do is set Bounce Combine to maximum. Do that now. Then you can test out again by pressing play. And now you can see that it has more bounce to it. But if we want it to keep bouncing forever, we should set bounciness to a value of 1. And we're going to make things a bit more interesting now. With your object roughly in the middle of the scene, reselect it and choose the Translate tool. Remember, you can use W on the keyboard to select that tool at any time. I'm going to drag it up so it's a little higher, and then from the Models folder, I'm going to locate my bench. So grab Prop Bench Work and drag that into the scene. Yet again, I'm going to put it on the Dynamic Objects layer, and I'm going to go into the Mesh Renderer and choose Use Light Probes, so that it's nicely lit by our dynamic lights. Then what I'm going to do is add a collider, because we're going to make our semiflange bounce off of the bench. So I'm going to go to Add Component, Physics, and nice and simply, I'm just going to add a primitive box collider to this. Then hover your mouse over the scene view and press F to focus on the object so that we can see it a little bit closer. Note that at various times, I'm holding down the Alt key on the keyboard to orbit around as I drag. Now I'm going to go to the Hand tool to effectively hide the translate handles, and I'm going to hold down Shift to adjust the boundaries of the collider. The reason I'm doing this is because I don't want it to bounce off of the top of the collider here. I'd rather it bounced off of the surface. So all I'm going to do now is hold down Shift and drag the top one until it's roughly in line with the top of the workbench mesh. Now what we're going to do is go back to the Translate tool, and I'm going to drag this upward, something like that. And now what I'm going to do is tilt it at an angle. So I'm going to go to my Rotate tool, which remember is E on the keyboard, and I'm going to tilt it, something like that. Then all I'm going to do is switch to an overhead view. So using the view gizmo in the top right of the scene view, click on the Y cog, and then I'm going to reselect my spherical prop samoflange, and I'm going to get my view in order, and then I'm going to drag with the translate tool until it's over the top. Note that I'm still in a perspective view, and if I want to go to an orthographic view, I can click the cube in the middle like that. So now if I zoom in, I can see exactly whether it's over the top. And I'm going to keep using the translate tool to position it where I want it. And remember that we can rotate round to side-on views as well to ensure that we're getting it in exactly the right place. And keep rotating around until we're happy. Then I'm going to click back on the cube in the middle of the gizmo to go back to my perspective view. Now all I'm going to do is just press play. And as you can see, our samoflange keeps bouncing around all over the environment. And that's it. Remember to save your scene and keep experimenting with the different values in the Physic Material asset to get different effects. Or refer to the Physic Materials lesson for more information.